So, the first activity is answer these questions. Some questions are given in this activity. So, we have to write the answers for the given questions. So, children, read the first question. So, what are terrestrial plants? Name any three terrestrial plants. So, children, read the question again. What are terrestrial plants? Name any three terrestrial plants. Children, in the starting of the lesson, we have already discussed the different types of plants. That is, there are three types of plants, mainly terrestrial plants, aquatic plants, and insectivorous plants. And again, the terrestrial plants are classified into four types. That is, the desert plants, plants of plains, plants of hilly areas, plants of marshy areas. So these four are the different types of terrestrial plants. So let us see the answer for the given question. So children, read the answer. Plants live on land are called terrestrial plants. Example, mango tree, coconut tree, and salt tree. So these are the examples for terrestrial plants. So those plants which live on the land are called terrestrial plants. So the terrestrial plants examples are mango tree, coconut tree, and salt tree. So children, note down this question and answer in your notebook. Children, see the second question. So read the second question. How does a desert plant adapt itself to desert conditions? Children, do you remember the conditions in desert areas? We have already discussed in the chapter. So in desert, the climate is very hot and the soil is full of sand and the availability of water is very, very less. That means the water present in the deeper regions of the soil and the climate is hot, temperature is very, very hot. So the plants which grown in that desert areas have to adopt some features to survive in that unfavorable climatic conditions. So let us see, how does a desert plant adapt itself to desert conditions? So let us see the answer. So children, read the answer. The desert plant has leaves which are reduced to spines. This helps in reducing the loss of water from the leaves. So children, so what features the desert plant adopt to survive in the desert? The first one is, the desert plants does not have leaves, just like general other plants. Because if the leaves are present to a tree, then water will be lost through the leaves, through the process called respiration. So if the water is lost in the desert plants, then they does not survive because the water is not available in the desert. So that's why in desert plants, there are no leaves and leaves are reduced to spines. So these spines prevent the desert plants from the loss of water. And these spines also prevents the desert plants from grazing animals. Then how the desert plants prepare their food if it does not have leaves? Yes. So in desert plants, the stem is in green color. So the stem prepares food. So this is about desert plants. So children, go to the next question. That is the third question. So children, read the third question. So what are called breathing roots? Give reason. So children, read the question once again. So what are called breathing roots? Give reason. So we have already discussed this breathing roots in the part of plants of marshy areas. So in marshy areas, the presence of water is more. That means a lot of water is there. And a sticky soil is there. This sticky soil does not allow the roots to breathe. So that's why in that areas the roots of the plants come out of the soil and breathe. So that's why those roots are called breathing roots. So children, see the answer and read the answer. In marshy areas, the roots cannot breathe. There, the roots come out of the soil and breathe. Such roots are called breathing roots. So in marshy areas, the soil is sticky. That's why that does not allow the roots to breathe. That's why they come out the soil and breathe. That's why those roots are called breathing roots. And examples for this breathing roots are the roots of mangroves. So children, note this question and answer in your notebook. So children, see the next question. That is fourth question. What are floating plants? Give two examples. So the fourth question is, what are floating plants? Give two examples. Children, we have already discussed about aquatic plants. The plants which live inside the water or on the water are called aquatic plants. In aquatic plants, there are again three types of plants. We have discussed the first one is floating plants, and the second type is fixed plants, and the third one is submerged plants. So the floating plants, what are floating plants? So children, see the answer for this question. So read the answer. The plants which float freely on the surface of water are called floating plants. Example, Lemina, Jessiaea, water hyacinth. So these are the example for the floating plants. So in these plants, so generally their stem is less and the roots are poorly developed. That means they have less stem and roots are poorly developed, and they will float on the surface of the water. That's why these plants are called floating plants. So example, Lemina, Jessiaea and water hyacinth. So children, note down this question and answer in your notebook. So go to the next question. So children, read the fifth question. What are insectivorous plants? Give two examples. So once again, the question is, what are insectivorous plants? Give two examples. Already we have discussed the terrestrial plants, aquatic plants, insectivorous plants are the three types of plants. So what are insectivorous plants? So children, let us see the answer for this question. So the answer is, some plants are insect eaters. They are known as insectivorous plants. Example, pitcher plant, Venus flytrap, sunjuice. So these are the examples for insectivorous plants. Children, we have discussed in our chapter insectivorous plants, that is, some plants does not have a greenery parts. That means that they does not have green parts to prepare their food. So these plants, these insectivorous plants, does not prepare their food by using photosynthesis. So they will depend upon small insects for their food. They will trap the insects and they will eat the insects and digest the insects, and they will absorb the nutrients they require. So that's why these plants are called insectivorous plants, because they eat insects. These are called insect eaters. So pitcher plant, Venus flytrap, sunjuice are examples. So children, note down this question and answer in your notebook. So children, go to the next question. So the next activity in the exercise is complete the sentences. So children, so look at the